Namo Namaha. Welcome back, dear students, to the yet another session of Sanskrit. In this online session, we are going to continue with the poem Sukti Mauktikam. In the previous session, we have seen the first four verses. Today, we are going to see the next four. So let's get started with the fifth verse. Here is the verse. I'll read it out. Guneshveva hi kartavyah. प्रयत्नः पुरुषैः सदा गुणयुक्तो दरिद्रोऽपि नेश्वरैरगुणैः समः. This verse is taken from the play मृच्छकटिकम. Let's see the words with संधिः or संयोगः from the given verse.
I'll mark the words with संधिः. गुणेष्वेव गुणयुक्तो दरिद्रोऽपि नेश्वरैरगुणैहि. Let's see the dissolution of these words. गुणेष्वेव, the dissolution is गुणेषु plus एव. गुणयुक्तो दरिद्रोऽपि, the dissolution is गुणयुक्तः plus दरिद्रः plus अपि. नेश्वरैरगुणैहि, the dissolution is न plus ईश्वरैहि plus agunaihi. Let's see the anvayaha of the verse. Here is the anvayaha. Purushaihi sada guneshu evahi prayatnaha kartavyaha. Gunayuktaha daridraha api agunaihi ishwaraihi samaha na. Arthat na bhavati. Now let's see the meanings of the words and the translation of the verse. Guneshveva hi kartavyah prayatnaha. Guneshu, regarding virtues. Prayatnaha kartavyah, should make efforts. Purushaihi, human beings. Sada, always. Human beings should always make efforts to enhance their virtues. Human beings should always make efforts to enhance their virtues. Gunayukto daridropi. Gunayuktaha, virtuous. Daridraha, poor. A virtuous poor person. Neshwaraira gunaih samaha. Ishwaraihi, rich people. Agunaihi, virtuous. Virtuous rich people. Na samaha, is not equal to. A virtuous poor person is not equal to many virtuous rich people. A virtuous poor person is not equal to many virtuous rich people. The translation of the verse is, human beings should always make efforts to enhance their virtues. A virtuous poor person is not equal to many virtuous rich people. It means he is better than many virtuous rich people.
In this verse, the poet has explained the importance of good qualities or virtues in our life. According to the poet, a virtuous person, even if he is poor, is better than a wealthy person who doesn't have any good qualities. After explaining this, the poet has given us an advice. We should always strive to enhance our good qualities, because material wealth is perishable. It can get destroyed. Only our qualities are going to remain with us. They will be with us forever. And that's why Guneshu eva hi kartavyah prayatnah purushaihi sada. I hope you have understood the verse. Now let's see Visheshan Vishesha Padani from the given verse.
Here are the Visheshan Vishesha Padani. The word Gunayuktaha is the Visheshanam of the word Daridraha. And the word Agunaihi is the Visheshanam of the word Ishwaraihi. Both the words Agunaihi and Ishwaraihi are given in the form of Sandhihi. Now let's see the next verse.
Here is the next verse. I'll read it out. try to understand the pronunciation of words. Arambha gurvi kshayini krameena lagvi pura vruddhi mati cha paschat dinasya purvardha parardha bhinna chhayeva maitri khalasajjananam. This verse is taken from Niti Shatakam. Let's see the words with sandhis from the given verse.
There is only one example of sandhi here, and it is chhayeva. The resolution is chhaya plus eva. Now let's see the anvayaha of the verse. Arambha gurvi krameṇa kshayini bhavati pura lagvi paschat cha vruddhimati bhavati dinasya purvardha parardha chhaya iva khalasajjananam maitri bhinna bhavati. Now let's see the meanings of the words and the translation. Arambha gurvi kshayini krameṇa. Arambha gurvi means it is long in the beginning. Kshayini krameṇa means becomes short with time. It is long in the beginning but becomes short with time. Lagvi pura vruddhi mati cha paschat. Lagvi pura, short in the beginning. Vruddhi mati cha paschat. Vruddhi mati becomes long or increases. Paschat, later. It is short in the beginning but becomes long or increases later. Dinasya purvardha parardha bhinna. Dinasya, of the day. Purvardha, the first half of the day, and parardha means the second half of the day. Bhinna, different. Chhayeva, like a shadow. Maitri, friendship. Khalasajjananam, of bad people and good people. The translation of the last two lines is, just as a shadow in the first half of the day is different from the second half of the day, so does the friendship of wicked people and good people. I'll repeat the translation of the entire verse. It is long in the beginning but becomes short with time. It is short in the beginning but becomes long later. Just as a shadow in the first half of the day is different from the second half of the day, similar is the friendship of bad people and good people.
In this verse, the poet has explained the difference between the friendship of wicked people and good or noble people. To explain this, he has given the example of the shadow. According to the poet, the friendship of wicked people is like the shadow in the first half part of the day. In the beginning, it is longer, but gradually it becomes shorter. If you will see, early in the morning, the shadow cast by the sun is always longer than the object itself. But as the day progresses and the sun is directly above, the shadow is exactly at the base of the object. The friendship of wicked people is exactly like this shadow. In the beginning, they are very much enthusiastic about the friendship. They would like to be with you. They would like to please you. But their friendship is mainly based on their selfish intentions. Once their intentions would get fulfilled, they start losing their interest in you and their friendship diminishes. Whereas the friendship of the noble people is like the shadow in the second half part of the day. In the beginning, it is shorter, but with the passage of time or as the time progresses, it becomes longer and longer. Good people or noble people are very cautious or careful about choosing their friends. In the beginning, their friendship is small, but in course of time, it grows and develops. It becomes deeper and more meaningful. So according to the poet, time is the true tasting ground of friendship, and we should always choose our friends carefully. obviously he wants us to be in the company of good people. The difference between the friendship of good people and bad people has been beautifully explained by the poet. There is one more verse which expresses the similar kind of thought. Anupurvam bruhat paschat bhavatyaryeshu sangatam viparitam anaryeshu yathechhasi tatha kuru. I hope you have understood the verse. Now let's see Visheshan Vishesha Padani from the given words.
Here are the Visheshan Vishesha Padani. The words Arambhagurvi, Kshayini, Laghvi, Vruddhimati and Bhinna are the Visheshanani of both the words Maitri and Chaya. Now let's see the next words.
Here is the next verse. Yatrapi kutrapi gata bhaveyur hamsa mahi mandala mandanaya hanestu tesham hi sarovaranam yesham maralai sahaviprayogah. The verse is taken from Bhamini Vilasah. Let's see the words with sandhihi or sanyogah from the given verse.
I'll mark the words with sandhihi. यत्रापि कुत्रापि गता भवेयुर हंसा मही मंडल मंडनाय एंड हानिस्तु. लेट्स सी द डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स. यत्रापि द डिसोल्यूशन इज यत्र प्लस अपि. कुत्रापि द डिसोल्यूशन इज कुत्र प्लस अपि. गता भवेयुर हंसा महिमंडल मंडनाय द डिसोल्यूशन इज गताः प्लस भवेयुः प्लस हंसाः प्लस महिमंडल मंडनाय एंड हानिस्तु. द डिसोल्यूशन इज हानिः प्लस तु. नाउ लेट्स सी द अन्वयः ऑफ द वर्ड्स. Here is the anvayah. Hamsaha yatra api kutra api mahi mandala mandanaya gataha bhaveyuhu. Hanihi tu tesham sarovaranam hi bhavati yesham maralaihi saha viprayogah bhavati. Now let's see the meanings of the words and the translation. Yatrapi kutrapi means anywhere. Gataha bhaveyuhu may go. Hamsaha swans. Mahi mandala mandanaya means they adorn the earth. The swans may go anywhere. They adorn the earth. Hanistu tesham hi sarovaranam. Hanihi means loss. Sarovaranam for lakes. He indeed. It is indeed a loss for the lakes. Yesham which maralaihi saha with swans. Viprayogah separation. It is indeed a loss for the lakes which experience separation from the swans. The translation of the entire verse is the swans may go anywhere, they adorned the earth. It is indeed a loss for the lakes which experience separation from the swans. The word maralaihi is used in Tritiya Vibhaktihi because of the indeclinable saha. Saha governs Tritiya Vibhaktihi.
This verse explains the importance of the company of good people. To explain that, the poet has beautifully used a metaphor of swans. Swan is a very beautiful and elegant bird. It catches our eyesight and it attracts our mind. Wherever the swans will be, they make that place look beautiful. But when the swans migrate from one place to other, or when they go from one lake to the other lake, the previous lake which they leave, it looks empty or it looks less beautiful. It means the lakes suffer the loss. In the same way, good people, wherever they will go, they will make that place more fortunate. But when they leave the place, or when they leave the people, that previous place or the people, they feel less fortunate. We can feel the absence of good people. So the poet has tried to explain here that we should always be in the company of good people. I hope you have understood the verse. Now let's see the Visheshan Vishesha Padani from the given words.
There is only one pair of Visheshan Vishesha Padam. The word Gataha is the Visheshanam of the word Hamsaha. Let's see the next verse.
Here is the last verse. Guna gunadneshu guna bhavanti, te nirgunam prapya bhavanti doshaha, asvadya toyaha prabhavanti nadyaha, samudram asadya bhavantya peyaha. This verse is taken from Hitopadeshaha. And students, if you remember, we have already learned this verse last year. Let's see the words with sandhihi or sanyogaha from the given verse.
I'll mark the words with sandhihi or sanyogaha. Guna gunadneshu, guna bhavanti, samudra masadya, and bhavantya peyaha. Let's see the dissolution of these words. Here is the dissolution of the words. Guna gunadneshu, the dissolution is gunaha plus gunadneshu. Guna bhavanti, the dissolution is gunaha plus bhavanti. Samudra masadya is the example of sanyogaha, and the dissolution is samudram plus asadya. And bhavantya peyaha, the dissolution is bhavanti plus apeyaha. Now let's see the anvayaha of the verse. Gunaha gunadneshu gunaha bhavanti, te nirgunam prapya doshaha bhavanti, asvadya toyaha nadyaha prabhanti, taha samudram asadya apeyaha bhavanti. Let's see the meanings of the words and the translation of the verse. Guna gunadneshu guna bhavanti. Gunaha means virtues. Gunadneshu, with those who understand virtues. Gunaha bhavanti, become virtues or prove to be virtues. Virtues prove to be virtues when they are with those who understand virtues. Te nirgunam prapya bhavanti doshaha. Nirgunam, the virtuous person, prapya, after reaching, doshaha bhavanti, become faults. They become faults after reaching the virtuous person. Asvadhyatoyaha prabhavanti nadyaha. Asvadhyatoyaha means those with tasty water. Prabhavanti, originate. Nadyaha, rivers. Rivers originate with tasty water. Samudram asadya bhavantya peyaha. Samudram, the ocean. Asadya, after reaching. Bhavanti apeyaha. Apeyaha means undrinkable or unfit for drinking. Samudram asadya bhavantya peyaha. But after reaching the ocean, they become unfit for drinking. I'll repeat the translation of the entire verse. Virtues prove to be virtues when they are with those who understand virtues. They become faults after reaching the virtuous person. Rivers originate with tasty water, but after reaching the ocean, they become unfit for drinking.
In this verse, the poet has explained the difference between the nature of a virtuous person and virtuous person. If a person himself has good qualities, then he can see and appreciate good qualities in others. If the person is virtuous, if he himself doesn't have any good qualities, then such a person always finds faults with others. He sees even good qualities as faults. To explain this, the poet has given the examples of rivers and the ocean. The rivers, when they originate, their water is sweet and tasty. It is potable. But when the rivers get merged into the ocean, the same water turns salty. In the same way, when good qualities are presented to a virtuous person, they become faults. That's why it is said that a virtuous person can only understand and appreciate the good qualities of others. I hope you have understood the verse. Now let's see a pair of Visheshan Vishesha Padani from the given verse.
Aswadhyatoyaha and Apeyaha are the Visheshane of the Visheshyam Nadyaha. Now let's see some important forms from the verse. Here are the two important forms from the verse, Prapya and Asadhya. Both the forms have the same meaning, that is, having reached or after reaching. Prapya has Pra-Upsargaha plus Aap Dhatuhu plus Lyap Pratyaha, and Asadhya has A-Upsargaha plus Sad Dhatuhu plus Nich Pratyaha plus Lyap Pratyaha. Students, Nich Pratyaha is not included in our syllabus. It is given here just for your information.
Students, we have seen four verses today. I have selected one of the verses and I'm going to ask you some questions based on it. So get ready to solve the questions.
Here is the verse. Students, take your time, solve the questions and then go to the part where the answers are displayed. Let's see the questions. Ekapadena uttarata, ke sarovaran vihaya gacchanti? The second one is, hanihi kesham bhavati? Purnavakyena uttarata, hamsaha kim mandanaya gacheyuhu? The second one is, sarovaranam katham hanihi bhavati? Bhashikarya questions. Maralaha iti padasya paryaya padam kim? The second one is, hamsaha gataha bhaveyuhu atra kriya padam kim? Labhaha iti padasya viloma padam kim prayuktam?
I know you have solved all the questions and are ready with your answers. Now let me take you to the Uttarani.
Ekapadena uttarata, ke sarovaran vihaya gacchanti? Who would go away leaving the lakes? The answer is hamsaha. Hanihi kesham bhavati? Who or what suffer the loss? And the answer is sarovaranam. Purnavakyena uttarata, hamsaha kim mandanaya gacheyuhu? What do the swans adorn when they go to any place? The answer is hamsaha mahi mandala mandanaya gacheyuhu. The next question is, sarovaranam katham hanihi bhavati? Why would the lakes be at loss? The answer is sarovaranam maralaihi saha viprayogena hanihi bhavati. Bhashikarya questions. Maralaha iti padasya paryaya padam kim? And the paryaya padam for the word maralaha is hamsaha. Hamsaha gataha bhaveyuhu atra kriya padam kim? And the kriya padam in the given sentences bhaveyuhu. Labhah iti padasya viloma padam kim prayuktam? And the viloma padam for the word labhah is hanihi. I hope your answers are correct.
So here ends the presentation. Students, I have not discussed the Abhyasaha today because I want to give it to you for homework. solve all the question answers given in the Abhyasaha. You can write the answers in your Sanskrit's notebook or on your worksheets. We will meet again with the next part. Dhanyavadaha, punarmilamaha.